wherein we will have the stress acting along only one direction. So this is how it will be. This is the element which is subjected to uniaxial stress system, sigma x and sigma x. This is the normal plane, this is the plane which is inclined at an angle theta with reference to vertical. Okay, in such case the normal stress sigma n is given by sigma x cos square theta. Okay, sigma x cos square theta will give you normal stress, and the tangential stress or shear stress, okay, that is tangential or shear stress sigma t or tau is given by sigma by 2 psi 2 theta, sigma by 2 psi 2 theta. Okay, that is the that is the equation for tangential or shear stress given by sigma x by 2 sin 2 theta. Theta is the angle with reference to vertical, angle of the plane with reference to vertical. Okay, and this is the normal stress. Normal stress sigma n is given by sigma x cos square theta. Now what you do is take out your data handbook which is given to you. Please take out your data handbook. Take out your data handbook. Look for the equation. What is the equation number which the print you should have taken? Now sigma n is for uniaxial stress system, sigma n is given by sigma x cos square phi, that is given by equation 1.6. What is the equation number? 1.6a in page number 4. Are you there with me? Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
You have your data handbook that I had sent to you with you?
In WhatsApp, sir, yes.
Yeah? Do you have the data handbook copy I had sent it to you?
Yes, sir.
All of you should keep the pages that I had sent it to you people. Please keep that open. Please keep that open. Okay? Next. The tangential stress is given by equation 1.6b. Okay, it is given by 1.6b in page number 4. This is for uniaxial stress system. Next, for biaxial stress system, next is biaxial stress system, wherein you have got the stress acting along two directions. Essentially it is given by something like this. This is sigma x, that's along x direction, and sigma y in y direction. Okay, so this is biaxial stress system. This is the plane which is inclined at an angle of theta with reference to vertical. When you have biaxial stress system, what is the equation for normal and tangential stress? Please look into your data handbook. What is the equation number for normal and tangential stress? Please see that. Please look into your data handbook. Yeah? What is the equation number? Biaxial stress, page number 4. You go to page number 4. 1.7a will give you normal stress, 1.7b will give us the shear stress, correct? Okay, so please note down that is the normal stress sigma n is equal to sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus sigma x minus sigma y by 2, then cos 2 theta or 2 phi. Okay, so it is cos 2 theta 1.7a that will give you the equation for normal stress. and the tangential stress sigma t or tau is given by equation 1.7b, that is sigma x minus sigma y by 2 sine 2 theta. Sine 2 theta will give you in page number 4, that's about biaxial stress system. Are you there with me? Are you there? Are you all there? Please note down. Yes. Please note down for uniaxial stress system and biaxial stress system. Note down the equation. Sigma n stands for normal stress. Sigma t or tau stands for tangential or shear stress. Okay. So that is sigma n, that is normal to the plane that is considered. This will give you sigma n, and along the parallel to the plane will give you sigma t or tangential stress. Okay, please note down. Please note down. Finished, huh? Did you finish?
Just a minute.
Finished?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Next, for triaxial stress system or plane stress system, so in a triaxial stress system, you will have stress along x-axis, sigma x, stress along y-axis, sigma y, and accompanied by shear stress, tau xy, okay? So this is the vertical effect cluster, this is the angle theta. When you have triaxial stress system or plane stress system, okay, the normal stress sigma n is given by sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus sigma x minus sigma y bar 2 cos 2 theta minus tau xy sin 2 theta. What is the equation number here? Please look into your data and book. And what is the equation number? 1.8 A in page number 5. Correct? Huh? There is the equation for normal stress. What is the equation for tangential stress? It is essentially given by sigma x minus sigma y by 2. Look at 1.8b. Okay? Sin 2 theta minus tau cos 2 theta. Is that correct? Is that correct? It is given by 1.8b, equation number 1.8b. And when you have the stress system, then you will get maximum principal stress equation and minimum principal stress equation. That is maximum principal stress is given by sigma 1. Okay, that is given by equation 1.8c. Please look at equation 1.8c. That is given by sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus root of sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square plus tau square. It's given by equation 1.8c. That will give you the maximum principal stress that we are going to get in the triaxial or plane stress system. And minimum principal stress is given by sigma x plus sigma y by 2 minus root of sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square plus tau square x1. This is given by equation in 1.8d. Is that correct? 1.8d will give you the minimum principal stress. This is minimum principal stress. And then what is it? What is the equation for maximum principal stress? Maximum shear stress? It's given by maximum shear stress. Maximum shear stress, tau max is equal to, you have either of the equations. You can use sigma x minus sigma y by 2 whole square plus tau square xy, or you can also use sigma 1 minus sigma 2 by 2. Any of these two equations will give you the maximum shear stress acting on a triaxial stress system on a plane which is inclined at an angle of theta with reference to vertical. Okay, the normal stress perpendicular to the plane considered, shear stress parallel to the plane considered, maximum principal stress which will give you the maximum stress because of combined effect of all the stresses in all the directions. Sigma 1 will give you maximum principal stress, sigma 2 will give you minimum principal stress, tau max will give you maximum shear stress acting on the element because of triaxial stress system. Are you there with me? Are you there? What is the equation number for tau max? Someone please tell me the equation number for tau max. Yeah?
So 1.8f.
1.8f, yeah. 1.8f, page number? Page number?
Page number 5, sir.
Five.
Page number 5. Others, do you have data handbooks with you? Keep that open. Please note down the equations. location of principal planes. That is, we need to find out theta p1 and theta p2. That is given by equation tan 2 theta p1 is equal to 2 tau xy divided by sigma x minus sigma y. Is that correct? Please check in your data and book. Tan 2 theta is given by 2 tau xy by sigma x minus sigma y. What is the equation number other than Siddharth? Darshan, what is the equation for principal planes number? What is the equation number in data handbook? Darshan, are you there?
Yes, sir.
What is the equation number?
For position also.
Huh?
1.8E.
Okay, so with this we will get first principal plane, add 90 degrees to that, we will get theta p2, that is the position of principal, maximum principal plane and the location of the minimum principal plane, sigma p1 and theta p1 and theta p2. Is that okay? So these are all the equations in a triaxial stress system. This is the equation for normal stress, tangential stress, maximum principal stress because of combined effect of all the stresses, minimum principal stress, then the maximum shear stress in the system and location of principal planes. What are principal planes? Principal planes are the planes where there is zero shear stress, and the stress acting on such planes are called the principal stresses. Correct? So the location of principal planes, that is the angle at which the principal planes are present, where you are going to get maximum principal stresses and minimum principal stress. So those planes, are the location of such plane is given by 2 tau xy by sigma x minus sigma y. Have you noted down all these equations into your notebook?
For 2 minutes, sir.
Yeah. Chinmay?
Yes, sir.
Give me the location of shear planes, that is direction of shear stresses. What is the equation? Direction of shear stresses.
Tan 2 phi s.
One second. Direction of shear stress, that is the location of shear planes. Tell me, tan 2 theta.
Tan 2 theta, yes, sigma x minus sigma y.
Yeah.
By?
Yeah.
2 tau xy.
2 tau xy. Equation number?
1.8g.
Yeah. Page number 5. Correct? Okay. So these are all the equations that we need to use to find out normal stress, tangential stress, maximum and minimum principal stresses, tau max, position of principal planes and position of shear planes. These are all the equations that we use for triaxial stress system or a plane stress system. Are you there with me? Have you all noted down the equations? Have you noted down the equations? Finished?
Yes, sir.
Did you finish? Are anybody needing time? Yeah, please let me know once you complete. Nishant M, are you present? Nishant. Yes, Nishant, is he there? By the time I take attendance, by the time you note down the equations, that would be ideal. Yes, hi Sumant.
Present, sir.
Abhishek GL. Abhishek. Abhishek GL. Abhishek Narayan. Abhishek Narayan. Adarsh Desai.
Present, sir.
Okay. Ajay Sunil.
Yes, sir.
Akram Anwar. Akshay Jadhav.
Yes, sir.
Mundiyur.
Present, sir.
Nambiya.
Present, sir.
Nadella.
Yes, sir.
Biban.
Present, sir.
Chinmayi.
Present, sir.
Next is Chandan Swaroop. Chandan Swaroop. Charishma.
Present, sir.
Darshan.
Present, sir.
Ibad Kausar. Ibad Kausar. Govindraj. Govindraj M. Jayant Reddy.
Present, sir.
Jayant Reddy. Purushottam Reddy.
Present, sir.
Okay, Purushottam Reddy.
Present, sir.
Ritiksha. Ritiksha.
Present, sir.
Bansali.
Present, sir.
Jitin Kumar.
Yes, sir.
Chaitanya Omshi. Karamjit Singh. Kartikeya Avasthi.
Present, sir.
Kartikeya Avasthi, okay. Kiran V. Kiran. Rastanullah. Mazin Omar. Sharan. Narendra. Nihal Shetty.
Yes, sir.
Nikhil.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Vagmesh.
Yes, sir.
Nitin. Nitin. Prajwal. Pranay. Prayag.
Yes, sir.
Next. Prince Prabhakar. Pinto.
Yes, sir.
Rakshit.
Yes, sir.
Rishi. Sandeep. Sanjay Gowda.
Yes, sir. Present, sir.
Sanjay N.
Yes, sir. Present, sir.
Pratish Shankar.
Yes, sir.
Saurabh Praveen.
Yes, sir.
Shivam Kumar. Shivam Kumar. Shivam Sundriyal.
Present, sir.
Shravan Saluja. People are on and going off. What is this? Srinidhi. Siddharth.
Present, sir.
Sanu.
Yes, sir.
Sudip KS. Sunil Kumar.
Yes, sir.
Sunil Kumar, you are attending only today?
Yes, sir.
God bless you. Tarun Pachauri.
Yes, sir.
Vinay. Vinay. Vipan Singh.
Yes, sir.
Vivek. Milan Chowdhury. Mule Patti.
Present, sir.
Saksham Singh.
Yes, sir.
Chaitanya Patej.
Yes, sir.
Mahesh Madiwal. Nishant. Ramesh. Shashank. Akshat.
Yes, sir.
Sautrik Roy. Mahima Raj.
Present, sir.
Sri Vatsan, Suman Xavier, Madan Kumar, Manu, Shadab, Ganesh, Vijay Kumar. Yeah.
Sir Vijay?
Yeah?
Sir Vijay Kumar, yes, sir. Vijay Kumar, sir.
Oh, Vijay Kumar, you are present, huh? You come and join only today, Vijay Kumar?
Yes, sir.
17ME 414, huh?
Yes, correct, sir.
Okay. So, what we have taken? You have taken the equations, right? Not on the problem now. This was asked for 8 marks in the examination. Please note down the problem. A rectangular bar of section. A rectangular bar of section 50 mm by 25 mm. A rectangular bar of 50 mm by 25 mm is subjected to a tensile load of tensile load of 25 kilonewton. Full stop. Determine the values of determine the values of normal and shear stresses on a plane 30 degrees with the vertical. On a plane 30 degrees with the vertical. Stop. Also calculate magnitude of maximum shear stress. Also calculate the magnitude of maximum shear stress. Also calculate the magnitude of maximum shear stress. Akshat B.S. Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Please read the problem.
A rectangular bar of section 50 millimeter by 25 millimeter is subject to a tensile load of 25 kilonewton.
Okay.
Determine the values of normal and shear stresses on a plane 30 degrees with the vertical.
Yeah.
Also calculate the magnitude of maximum shear stress.
Yeah. Okay. Please look here, all of you. There is a rectangular bar which is having a cross section of how much? 50 by, this is 50 mm and this is 25 mm, correct? This is subjected to an axial tensile load of 25 kilonewton. Is that correct, Akshat? 25 kilonewton, no? 25 kilonewton. Right, note, Akshat?
Yes.
Okay. It is subjected to an axial tensile load of 25 kilonewton. So when I take the cross section separately, this is how the rectangular cross section 50 by, this is 50 mm, okay, this is 25 mm cross section, rectangular cross section, which is subjected to an axial tensile load of 25 kN. We need to find out normal and shear stresses on a plane which is inclined at an angle of how much with reference to vertical? How much with reference to vertical?
30 degrees.
30 degrees, okay. So this is the vertical line. This plane is inclined at an angle of 30 degrees. On that plane, we need to find out normal stress and the tangential stress sigma t. Are you with me? In simple terms, I write like this. This is subjected to, this is a rectangular cross section subjected to 25 kN. Okay, and 25 kN. This is the vertical and the plane which is inclined at an angle of 30 degrees with reference to vertical. We need to find out normal and tangential stresses. What is the type of stress system is this? Is it a uniaxial stress system or biaxial or triaxial stress system? Which is the type of stress system is this?
Uniaxial.
Uniaxial stress system. What is the equation for normal stress in uniaxial stress system? Sigma n is equal to?
Sigma x cos square theta.
Sigma x cos square theta. Correct? Huh? Are you there? Correct? Huh? Yes. Others?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So how do you find out sigma x? Sigma x is equal to load by area of cross section is what we learned. Right? So that is the normal stress. What is the load? So data you can write down. P is equal to 25 into 10 power 3 Newton. Area of cross section is 50 by 25. That's equal to how much? 1250 mm square. Correct? This is the data that is given. And theta is equal to 30 degrees with reference to vertical. This is the data that we have got from the given problem. So load, it is subjected to an axial load of 25 kN, that is 25 into 10 power 3 Newton. Area is 50 mm by 25 mm, that is equal to, what is the value of sigma x from this? Someone 20. Give me the value of sigma x.
20.
20 megapascal, correct. Okay, 20 megapascal. So therefore, the normal stress sigma n is equal to 20 into cos square. What is angle theta? 30 degrees. Correct? Huh? So what is the value of normal stress? What is the value of sigma n now? 20 into cos square 30. Give me the value of normal stress. What is the normal stress that is acting on a plane which is inclined at an angle of 30 degrees? What is the value?
15, sir.
Yeah, it is?
15
megapascal, correct? Okay. And what is the tangential stress? What is the equation given by? Sigma x by 2. What is the equation?
Sine 2 theta.
Yeah?
Sigma x by 2, sine 2 theta.
Sine 2 theta. Okay, that is 20 by 2, sine 2 into 30 is sine 60. What is the value? Babita, give me the value of Babin Kalita. Biban Kalita. Give me the value of sigma t. Biban, are you there? Yeah, others at least give me the value. Sigma t.
2.5 megapascals.
Yeah, how much?
2.5.
Calculate it again. Tangential stress is sigma x by 2 sine 2 theta.
Sir, 8.66?
Yeah, correct. It is 8.66 megapascal. That is the value of tangential stress. So the tau max for uniaxial stress system is given by sigma x by 2, that is equal to 20 by 2, that is equal to 10 megapascal. Okay? These are the values. Anybody? Any doubt? Chaitanya Patted, any doubt in this?
No, sir.
Could you understand?
Yes, sir.
So it is a uniaxial stress system with a cross section of 50 by 25 mm subjected to axial tensile load of 25 kN. Okay. So that is axial load is 25 kN. I have converted it into Newton by multiplying it by 10 power 3. Area of cross section is given by, it's a rectangular cross section, 50 by 25 will give us area of cross section. And in the problem, it is given on the plane, that is, which is at an angle of 30 degrees with reference to vertical. On that plane, we need to find out normal and tangential stress. So for a uniaxial stress system, normal stress is given by sigma x cos square theta. Sigma x is load by area of cross section, will give us 20 megapascal. Substitute in the normal stress equation, you will get the value of normal stress. Similarly, tangent stress equation, use that, you will get tangential stress equation. Tau max is given by normal stress divided by, the sigma x is divided by maximum normal stress divided by 2 will give us maximum shear stress. Are you there with me? Are you there? Could you understand?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, those who want to note down, please note down. Those who are not done, please note down the solution. Please note down the solution. Shall I remove this? Yeah, take the next problem. Take the next problem. Anybody needing more time there?
Yes, sir, 1 minute.
Yeah. Vibhat Kosar, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Where were you when I took the attendance?
Sir, network issue, sir. Suddenly disconnected.
Now it is connected. How it is connected? Your name was there. There was no network issue. You switched it on and went, I suppose. Correct? Huh?
No, sir.
Okay. Nishant. Nishant is present now, at least. See? But Nishant has switched on and he has, I think, gone for sleep. Chinmayi, finished that?
So we can't see the last part. Can you like just bend your camera?
Yeah, can you? Sigma T, do you? Yeah, is that visible?
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. When it's finished, we'll go to the next problem. Chinmayi, finished that? Chinmayi?
Yes, sir.
Finished, huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Right. We'll go to the next problem then. A rectangular bar of cross section, please note down. A rectangular bar of cross section. A rectangular bar of cross section. 220 mm by 50 mm. 220 mm by 50 mm is subjected to a tensile load F as shown in figure. Full stop. The allowable normal and shear stresses on the oblique plane BC on the oblique OB, LI, QUE, oblique plane BC, on the oblique plane BC, or 9 megapascal and 4.5 megapascal respectively, or 9 megapascal and 4.5 megapascal respectively. Full stop. Determine the safe value of load F. Determine the safe value of load F. Determine the safe value of load F. Okay, Jayant Bansali, you are there, no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please read the problem. Please read out the problem. Others, please look at your books.
Sir, I'm actually traveling. I'm not writing.
Yeah?
Sir, I'm actually traveling. I cannot write.
Yeah, traveling. Where are you traveling now? Yes.
I'm going to the airport.
What I say? What is this? Then what class? Not ready. It's traveling to airport. Jitin Kumar.
Varun.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, have you written or you are also traveling?
No, sir, I have written.
Please read the problem. Others, please look into your books.
A rectangular bar of cross section 220 by 50 is subjected to a tensile load F as shown in figure.
Okay.
Allowable normal and shear stresses on the oblique plane BC are 9 megapascal and 4.5 megapascal.
Okay.
Determine the safe value of load F.
Determine the safe value of load F. Okay. So we'll take up this problem in the next class. All of you, please have printout of data handbook. Okay. Go through switching on and going off. Right. These are all, one second. I'll stop recording.